name Sotonye Ogan?
Yes.
Indeed. Very tough name. Very unique name. Also very tough name to pronounce, especially for people with thin lips.
That's what she said. She's in agreement, you know?
Thin lips. The ideal lips for making laws and policies. But not so ideal lips for pronouncing Nigerian names. That's, you know, that's what private school taught me. You know, surprise, this black dude went to private school. Couldn't you tell? Yeah. From the sketches? Not too many black dudes wearing sketches. You know, which is a shame, you know? Because actually, these are more than capable shoes. Soft material. You know, bouncy sole. In my opinion, the ideal footwear for running away from trouble. That's our pitch into the street. Now, if only the hood would listen to me. I grew up rich in a poor neighborhood. A bit of a mind screw. I'm like the opposite of the Fresh Prince. Because he grew up poor in a rich neighborhood. I'm not the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, but I'm the Fresh Prince of Stockwell. So please put some respect on my title. Yeah, I love the laughter. Slightly distracting. You know what, Jackie? I'm going to plow through. Because I am feeling myself. That's right. You can tell I was different, you know. Right. For example, I was the only kid from my era who did dinghy sailing during the summer. All of the men them were out buying the latest Nike tracksuits. I was out purchasing the latest Rip Curl wetsuits. So, that was my life. My dad was the one with money, And I remember as a kid not trusting him or his wealth. Because I grew up in the 90s. So if you were black, male, and loaded, but not a footballer, then you were a drug dealer. I didn't make up this rule. Those were the rules on the streets. Now, my dad is, and was, and still is 5'6" and a beast. All right? So I knew for a fact that this black Oompa Loompa was no sportsman. For the first 18 years of my life, I thought my dad was the black PABLO ESCOBAR. Southwest London's godfather of crack cocaine. I thought I was the son of a killer. Imagine that. My 19th birthday, found out that Dad actually just owned a travel agency. Still selling packages, just, that's a slow burner. Crazy. A lot of thin-lipped people behind this Brexit mess. It's crazy, man. At least you admit to it, that's right. No self-denial's a bad thing. No, it's true, it's crazy, because before this whole Brexit mess, I just used to see myself as English, but post-Brexit, it's hit me that I'm actually the son of two immigrants, neither of my parents were born here. Dad's Nigerian, mom's Jamaican, I'm just a volatile mixture of black. Because not many people know this, but Jamaicans and Nigerians, they're not the best of buds, My parents are no exception, my dad hates my mom hates my dad, I hate them both because I'm trying to stay neutral. I am literally the black equivalent of being half Israeli and half Palestinian. Except the Nigerians and Jamaicans, we're not even fighting over a border. Because we do not share a border. Actually, tell a lie, we do. This border's called Campbellwell. Campbellwell Greens, help East London's Gaza Strip. It's hard being mixed black. Not many people know about this struggle. It's not a struggle because of white oppression. It's actually a struggle because of black oppression. Dad wants me to be Nigerian. Mum wants me to be Jamaican. I just want me to be free. Of all blackness, I'd happily give up all this black beauty for peace of mind. Because you know what they say, more melanin, more problems. My mum recently did a, you know, that DNA ancestry test? You heard about this? She recently took one of those, and I didn't know what to expect, but she was 100% certain, man, that her results would come back as black. Just black. Nothing else, not African, not Caribbean, just black. Because obviously...